It's Thursday, July 25th. The International Space Station's Expedition 36 crew members have split their attention today among continuing science operations, their daily maintenance of their home on orbit, and preparations for the departure of one of their cargo ships. The hatch to the Russian cargo craft Progress 50 was closed on Wednesday morning after the crew members had finished filling that vehicle with trash and other items that are no longer needed on board. On Thursday morning, Station Commander Pavel Vinogradov and Flight Engineer Fyodor Yurchikhin had a conference with the team at the Mission Control Center outside Moscow to review procedures that they might have to follow in the event that there was an issue during the undocking and the crew members had to take over manual control of that Progress in order to redock the vehicle to the station. But they will be standing by when 50P disengages from the pier's docking compartment at 3:44 Houston time this afternoon. The Progress vehicle will then follow its programmed course to back away from the station and begin the final leg of its journey, which will end with a destructive entry into the atmosphere above the Pacific Ocean. That docking port at the aft end of the piers module will be taken by another Progress vehicle this coming Saturday night. And since the crew members will be working to support those docking activities over the weekend, Vinogradov, Yurchikhin, and Flight Engineer Alexander Mazurkin all had a half a day off duty on Thursday and are scheduled for a full day off duty on Friday. Flight Engineer Chris Cassidy started his Thursday with science operations. He worked to set up hardware in the Kibol laboratory module for upcoming runs with the Marangoni experiment. In that investigation, scientists are using the Marangoni convection to study the properties of heat transfer that take place in a microgravity environment. Flight Engineer Luca Parmitano spent his morning at the combustion integrated rack. He was working to install new hardware components in an apparatus known as the multi-user droplet combustion apparatus, which you see in his hands. He's installing new components there for the next set of combustion experiment runs. There are several such investigations currently on the schedule, all of them dedicated to learning the details about how different fuels burn in the absence of gravity. That's all designed to improve fire safety and fire suppression techniques, but also to increase the efficiency of engines which use liquid fuels. The plan for Flight Engineer Karen Nyberg's morning was devoted to preparing for next month's arrival of the H2 transfer vehicle. That is the fourth cargo ship to the station provided by the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. Nyberg and the Japanese flight control team ran into some difficulties powering up the HTV's hardware control panel on both the primary and the backup system. There is a cable that is suspected of being bad. Well, there are several other spare cables on board, but the troubleshooting of that apparatus is still underway. Nyberg also spent time checking out the laptop computer that she'll use in her refresher training of HTV grapple and berthing operations. She'll be at the command of the station's arm for those operations next month. After their lunch, Nyberg and Cassidy took time to talk about the progress of their mission in interviews with the Washington Post and the Portland, Maine Press Herald, the newspaper in Cassidy's home state. Throughout the day, all six crew members got in their two exercise sessions, getting a workout either on a stationary bike, a treadmill, or resistive exercise, something that all crew members do every day in order to keep generally fit, and also to try to keep them in good shape for when they encounter gravity again at the end of their missions. On Friday, the Russian crew members will be off duty, but will take care of their weekly house cleaning that's usually scheduled for Saturday. Meanwhile, Chris Cassidy and Karen Nyberg are scheduled to conduct more troubleshooting on the spacesuit that leaked water into Luca Parmitano's helmet during a spacewalk last week as the crew members work in coordination with the ground teams in Houston to try to isolate the source of that leak, the cause of the problem. Parmitano, on Friday, will work on the surface telerobotics experiment. And from orbit, he will remotely drive a rover that's on a test ground at the Ames Research Center in California. All of the crew members looking forward to the arrival of a new load of supplies that is due to arrive at the station in a new Progress vehicle scheduled to dock to the pier's docking compartment on Saturday night, Houston time.